It is. May the Force and may the Force be with you.
The Force will be with you. Always.
In celebration of this religious occasion, why don't I take you poor buggers on a trip down memory lane? 40 years of fandom, 15 years using my day job as an excuse to get up close and personal with some of my greatest Star Wars heroes. The reality is, when I stop and think about it, I have been so lucky. 15 years I've been doing this gig, I've had to fly all around the world constantly.
Thank you. Oh, thank you.
And I cannot even begin to list the pinch me moments in the context of all of that, whether it's on a film set, or whether it's sitting down at a junket in a hotel room. I still feel like a little girl, and you just mesh Star Wars into that.
And a warning, this story contains a little bit of high-pitched screaming.
If you've ever wanted to know how to lose your voice in less than 12 parsecs, well, it goes a little bit like this.
The first interview I got in a galaxy far, far away was on the Skywalker Ranch, and it was with George Lucas himself, unbelievably the godfather of the galaxy. I definitely needed rescue remedy for that. It was enough to be on the Skywalker Ranch itself, but to sit down with George Lucas was amazing. Sydney was the premiere for The Force Awakens. I did go to LA for the premiere, didn't get red carpet access, but while I was filming the fans beforehand, who walks up but Anthony Daniels, who plays C-3PO, in love with New Zealand, immediately gave me a 20-minute interview, and what a charming delight he was. A couple of days later in Sydney, Harrison Ford flew down under, legendarily grumpy to interview, but I found him utterly charming in his gruffness.
But I think he was very understated for me, and I was pretty happy. It was a dream come true.
And the awesome thing about that is before cameras were rolling, they needed to do some tweaks to the lighting, and I got to stand to the side for, I don't know, 8 minutes and just chat with him before we sat down for the interview. And he was, as you can imagine, amazing. There's a couple of other people I interviewed there. One of them was Adam Driver, of course. The other was Rian Johnson, director extraordinaire of The Last Jedi. And the most awesome thing about that was, is he took my photo. It was weird. He was taking photos of journalists, and then later that day he posted them on Instagram. I know, it's the little things. I loved it. I cannot even begin to explain that my heart was in my mouth when I walked in to sit down with Mark Hamill.
I'm Kate from New Zealand.
Very nice to meet
so
you.
So nice to meet you. What a pleasure.
Look at how you're themed to the movie.
And at the end of the interview, he wrapped me up in the biggest hug. And once I left the room, of course, I burst into tears. I'm not embarrassed to say it. I'm not embarrassed to confess that after 5 minutes of joy with the wonderful Mark Hamill, I had a wee cry. I think you'll all agree that's quite enough of my trip down at memory lane, and thank you for indulging me.
Would you agree? Mandalorian, look outside. They are waiting for you.
Right, if you haven't actually seen The Mandalorian, what the hell have you been doing on lockdown, and who are you? For a free trial, go to Disney Plus. You may be wondering why we should all be getting so excited about a behind-the-scenes docu-series of the making of a Star Wars TV show. The minute I heard that it was happening, it kind of transported me back to that moment in the Dark Ages where there was a one-hour special that was shown on my little black and white TV on how George Lucas made the first original Star Wars A New Hope, with all of the tiny models, with everything that was involved. I remember each and every frame of that documentary. It was such a fascinating glimpse into the movie that I had fallen in love with as an 8-9-year-old and had watched 8 or 9 times in the cinema.
Oh, my poor circuits. It's all so very complicated. I don't see how they ever put all this together. Well, really, R2, of course we all want to see how it worked out.
So, behind the scenes now is nothing new. The fact that this is 8 episodes, and the fact that Disney's making such a big deal about it, what that told me immediately was that they had shot this doco for purpose, that they had always intended to. It wasn't just a cash grab where they thought, oh, we've got all of this B-roll of production sitting on the editing room floor, why don't we make a doco? I think they set out to make this documentary when they started making The Mandalorian, and that is reason to get excited.
They built him out of parts of the old cantina set from A New Hope. We, as children, like that. It's the coolest assassin robot. It was bolted to the floor.
We're trying to to draw from all over Star Wars.
We remember the great special effects when they're first used. What about Alfred Hitchcock and his dolly zoom? Stanley Kubrick's shining Steadicam, and I mean, who the hell hasn't had their mind blown by bullet time? The Mandalorian teamed up with Industrial Light and Magic, and they magicked up something truly spectacular from behind the scenes, and it's so seamless that it needs an entire 8-episode documentary just to convince us they're not making it up.
We can have game engine, real-time render, and video wall technology coming together to create a backdrop for the big, beautiful world of Star Wars.
Extraordinary number of benefits and advantages for shooting in that environment. It's mind-blowing what that tool is.
And Taika Waititi, God, doesn't he make us Kiwis feel so proud? Obviously, he's no stranger to the Disney Marvel sandpit, because he made a film for Marvel. God, what was it? Thor Ragnarok. Did I mention that I had a hand in getting him his Star Wars gig? Yep, it was me. 2017, I had a sit down with Kathleen Kennedy, Lucasfilm president, of course, and, you know, just casually mentioned it.
We think he should direct a Star Wars movie.
Well, I would love for him to direct a Star Wars movie. And I do, I agree. I think he has exactly the right sensibility.
I took you, that was kind of a job offer, don't you think? It was right there.
Yeah.
And now, of course, the rumor mill is lapping it up. I know, I can't take all the credit. He's kind of a great filmmaker. It goes without saying, making an 8-episode behind the scenes of The Mandalorian was always going to please me. The idea of getting all those amazing directors, including Taika, but of course Dave Filoni, and also Jon Favreau, sitting around, just shooting the breeze and talking about making it. And then obviously getting to see Taika on set calling action, getting to see the technology at work, but also getting to see the real nitty gritty in the process, and how you get those performances, the stylized look of it, but also the camera shots that you're getting to see of the camera shots of them making the show. This kind of stuff is like crack to me. I'm struggling to find a better way to spend my night.
Yeah, good.
I have spoken. And honestly, if you don't get that, you bloody well better go and watch The Mandalorian right now.